speak with me.
Hey. Say something?
Hi, Norton.
Well, here we are again on another fine edition of Uppercut. I'm Dave.
I'm Norton Nash.
And I'm Tracy.
And we're here today to play some music for you and to play a little interview we have with Jenny Friedland, who is an independent candidate for mayor. And actually, she's speaking at Hart House right now. So for those
and for
of you,
the next 2 hours,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah, for the next 2 hours. So for those of you that are really bored and don't want to listen to our show, whip on down to Hart House and see the mayor's duke it out. Anyway, we're going to play some tunes. Isn't that right, Pete?
Yeah. On July 27th, a 20-year-old in Rockwell, Texas was driving in his vehicle and pulled over by police for speeding. Police officers saw a Nova Mute Rickards plastic man sheet, one compact disc. Police believe the perforated sheet looked like blotter LSD and arrested the man and held him for 5.5 days. He was released on $5,000 bail and must go to court August 23rd to determine if he will be charged with the schedule one second degree felony of possessing a controlled substance all over a CD jacket cover. Mute Rickards couriered a sealed CD to Texas police to show it was, quote, just cover art.
That's ridiculous.
Someone's been arrested for carrying around a CD.
That's ridiculous.
While we're on the topic of being arrested for ridiculous things, there's a announcement in the latest marijuana and hemp newsletter out of Hemp BC. And it says, you're asked to boycott the following businesses for their explicit support and financial donations to promote the vicious war on drugs. Please do not buy Budweiser products, as Budweiser is the largest corporate sponsor of the rapidly prohibitionist Partnership for a Drug-Free America. That's the commercials that I'm sure you've seen on television. And they also mentioned that TD Bank does extensive and intrusive urine testing, so if you don't like that, you know, close
don't
your
join
account.
The Guardian Angels.
Yeah, that too. Why do they do urine tests?
Yeah, you have to be. You can't have a serious criminal record if you want to be a protector.
A protector of law and order.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, how about we cut for some music and come back with the interview we had?
You
going to
play
night.
That grasshopper?
Sure. Why not? Born loser on CIUT. We'll be right back.
in the studio, we got, well, speaking of Grasshopper, we got Dirk.
9-2-point Trey continues jazz.
And we got Alex from Ghettovision, and, well, I don't know.
That's me.
Yo, Alex, what up?
What's going on, man? We got this show tonight. We got the Killer Rock show. We got the Killer Hip Hop show. Tuesday night, Sneaky Dees, Grasshopper Project 9, the Ghettovision show. What do you got to say about that, Derek?
Yeah, I'm just lounging here, lounging strictly.
Just doing what you do.
Hey, you know, it's a come on down. There's going to be free Halloween candy that the parents didn't hand out last night. And Peter's going to be dressed up as a big rabbit playing bongos, giving out fireballs for Christmas. It's an early Christmas present for all you kids.
Yeah.
And I think there's combat boots at the door. You're not allowed to wear them into the club, but
no, there's no combat boots tonight. There'll be a combat boot check outside, a couple doors away.
And there's flexing, always flexing.
Yeah, there's always flexing. Yeah, so I hope you guys have picked up your copy of Ghettovision, which you can get at fine stores in the tri-state area. We got all kinds of the
source
good.
And pages.
What?
Look beside the source and pages.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
Tucked there ambiguously.
yeah, okay. We're beside the Anarchist
okay.
Weekly and
okay.
Pages.
We gotta get to this.
Yeah, we got an interview with Jenny Friedland, independent candidate for mayor of Toronto.
Who's apparently really nice.
Yeah, she's really cool. We talked to her last night a little bit about her. Election is coming up, so here's the interview that we got.
Spark it up.
Today with Jenny Friedland, who's running for mayor of Toronto in the upcoming election. How are you doing today, Jenny?
I'm doing well, thank you for asking.
Okay, great. So Jenny, for some of our listeners out there who may not be familiar with you, maybe you could tell them a little bit about yourself and what it was that led up to your running for mayor in the first place.
Probably the most important thing about me in terms of my candidacy for mayor is that I'm not a politician. I'm a school teacher. I also just finished a master's degree at U of T, and I operate a little street-level counseling service down on Queen Street. The reason I'm interested in running for mayor, or what motivated me in the first place, followed some remarks made by our present mayor, June Rowlands, regarding buskers in front of the Eaton Center. Remember when she said she tried to remove them and the council was trying to pass a law and it's actually being enforced now, they're being ticketed, to get buskers off the street. And I don't know June Rowlands' comments exactly, but it was something along the lines of, I feel uncomfortable down there. And I thought to myself, well, I don't, and most of the people I know don't, and I wondered who's actually representing us, and are they representing us, or are they representing an elite few?
Exactly is your platform. Where do you stand, especially on the busker issue, and some of the other issues that seem to be coming up, like crime and police? Throughout this election, we hear about crime and police, and more crime, and more police, and cleaning up the streets.
Yeah, you have to understand that the issues, as far as the mainstream goes, those aren't necessarily the issues. I mean, a lot of us feel excluded from the process, primarily because the issues being talked about aren't necessarily our issues.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm hesitant to even come out with a platform, primarily because we all know that a platform is bogus. I'm not going to come out and say that I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. Ultimately, the mayor's position is not overly political anyway. She or he is just a member of council. But definitely, as I say in my brochure, and to anyone who's willing to listen, as far as what this city needs, and perhaps I'll just read to you, it needs less traffic in the downtown core, more bike lanes, more humane policing, increased communication amongst levels of government, the citizens they claim to represent, safety for women, preservation of heritage buildings and neighborhoods, fewer superstores. I think we're all pretty tired of seeing pink and green condos going up and taking the place of lovely old buildings. Mm-hmm. Drinking water would be nice. Extended TTC hours. We definitely have to start forcing the viability of TTC in order to encourage fewer cars. Stronger enforcement of recycling policy, reduction of garbage, more buskers. I think buskers actually lend a great deal of life to this city. Increased support for artists. I mean, that's historically significant. Obviously, you know, no symphonies would be ever have made if the kings and whatnot weren't giving their money. And so to think, or someone like Meinzer, who comes out and says that given the success of commercial productions such as Miss Saigon and The Phantom, it's easy to see that the arts can pay their way if only they try. that's clearly a crock of shit, if I may say so on the radio.
Mm-hmm. And especially now, Metro Council, when it comes to funding of gay and lesbian theater.
Don't even get me started. I mean, we've got to fund the arts as much as we can. Mm-hmm. B, we've got to get rid of the bureaucracy that determines what's art and what isn't. Artists should be the ones that are deciding what should be promoted or given funding, not a bunch of guys in suits sitting in an office who are going to say that Miss Saigon needs funding or whatever it is they might say. Furthermore, to actually give grants and then to pull them like they did for Buddies in Bad Times or Inside Out is just preposterous, clearly. I mean, we have to give freedom to express, and we have to give money because artists can't earn their own way or they're not going to do their art. And if Toronto has anything, it's got a lot of great artists.
Definitely.
But back to my platform. Okay. what else am I into? I think we have to certainly deal with the overlap between government services with the city and Metro. Whether the city should pull out of Metro, I'll let June Rollins worry about that for now. But clearly something must be done because there is a lot of overlap and a lot of our dollars are going to things that don't need to be done. I'd like to see better inspection of low-income housing. I think safety standards aren't always being met. I'd like to see education in this town, but of course that's a provincial concern. But clearly our education system is lacking.
And especially now with the elections coming up and you have these cure candidates who are basically, they have a platform to leave homophobia and getting homosexuals out of the schools. Any sort of education that even refers to homosexuals, they don't want it in the schools.
But this is just bullshit, and that brings me to my final point on my platform, reduction of bullshit. I mean, it just seems, and it seems that there's a split in the city pretty much, or in the world at large, between people who are open-minded and flexible and are willing to let people do what they want as long as they're not hurting anyone else, and people who are still trying to pull the old moral high point on everyone else. And that is ridiculous. I mean, you can't. Removing the discussion of homosexuality in the schools means that you're going to end up with a lot more gay bashers. Simple as that. You know, I mean, I can go on and on about education, even if you want to talk about whether we should have zero tolerance for violence, so that kids are being expelled, right, if they're violent. I look at that and I say, kids who are being violent in school are obviously not into being in school in the first place. Therefore, removing them from school, expelling them, is probably a bonus in their eyes, and then they take their violence on the street and they don't learn, blah, 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 blah. There are many other solutions to that. Stick a kid in a room, give him a book, let him earn his way out when he's learning something. I don't know. I
mean, yeah, exactly, and like especially these people who are getting kicked out of school for violent acts are obviously the ones who need to be educated and need some form of job training because they're probably sick of the system as it is, and you know the only reason they're getting into violent acts is you know a form of rebellion. So by kicking them out of the school system altogether, it's not solving the problem, it's actually creating a much bigger one in the future.
Well, that's why I think I'm coming out as an absolute alternative in terms of an alternative just to the traditional way of thinking about everything as well, I mean, which can lead us nicely into the whole crime issue, because if you listen to Jerry Meinzer or June Rollins, all they keep saying is they're going to crack down on these after-hours clubs, they're going to put more police on the street, blah, 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 blah. Well, as far as I can tell, and as far as anyone I know can tell, the cracking down on after-hours clubs is only going to remove the problem once again. It's not like that's going to, if they catch some criminals, fine, that'll tie up our jails. If they don't, all it means is that the criminals will go elsewhere. Also, if you think about why are there criminals in after-hours clubs, well, only because it's a criminal activity to be drinking after hours. And why is that? Because we are not allowed to drink after 1 o'clock in establishments. And you would never tell a lawyer who's working that he can't go for a drink after his job's over. But we are continually telling everyone in the service industry, TTC, anybody who works late hours, that they have to go home and go to sleep. And that's crap. There is no nighttime-daytime distinction anymore. Which then can also flow into the whole question about raising revenue. Obviously, if we had extended bar hours, and I hear that they are thinking about giving municipalities jurisdiction over how they operate, and we all see in Toronto that it's easy to have extended bar hours when big business, NBA World Series comes, or when the Du Maurier Jazz Festival or the Festival of Festivals comes. We're not having extended hours for the festivals that are specifically Toronto, like the Fringe Festival or Roundup, or any of the other festivals that are specifically Toronto. And so it's clear to see that big business connection again We all know raising we all know that extending borrowers would raise revenue and solve a lot of that problem with the after hours thing.
Okay, now you also get into a little bit about legalized prostitution and decriminalization of certain products which people smoke but don't inhale and never buy.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to admit to anything, eh? Mm-hmm. But, well, again, these aren't municipal issues, right? Mm-hmm. But first one, legalized prostitution, you were at that Parkdale all candidates meeting where the first question was, Parkdale is pretty much the good, the bad, and the ugly. And the good, the questioner referred to was, you know, the homeowners and the families, and the bad and the ugly were the crack dealers and the prostitutes. Mm-hmm. And I think we just have a horrendous way, generally, of speaking about people who are people, not mm-hmm. just the scum of the earth, but people who were not born evil and obviously could do with some assistance in not becoming prostitutes or crackheads and whatnot. So I find that offensive in the first place. Legalized prostitution, it is legal, it's not decriminalized. Clearly, that would do a lot to being able to regulate it in terms of safety and issues regarding AIDS. It would get rid of the pimps. It would mean we could have perhaps a red light district, which could be pleased with lights and whatnot, where women can take care of themselves.
All
I mean,
all these community groups are always going on about how they want prostitution away from their children and away from their homes.
Well, and yeah, and if they want prostitution off the streets, I mean, the best thing to do is legalize it, give them a legalized brothel where they have AIDS tests, there's no pimp to smack them around.
Yeah, maybe we could turn a Greenwood racetrack into a brothel.
That would be a great idea.
Like in Amsterdam.
As for the decriminalization of certain products which people smoke but don't inhale and never buy, I mean, again, I'm not afraid to say that I think the criminalization of marijuana is probably one of the most ridiculous laws we have. I understand that a lot of people have a fear that pot leads to heroin, leads to one thing and another, but that's just a myth. I don't know anyone who smokes pot that also smokes heroin. I know people do, but it's certainly not a gateway. There's never any proof whatsoever of any ill effects health-wise, whereas we know for a fact that you can die from alcohol. Mm-hmm. You cannot die from smoking the old ganja there. Mm-hmm. But never mind as well, again, a source of revenue, and again, as well, the court costs nowadays in busting people that aren't criminals. It's almost like if every pot smoker actually came out of the closet, you know, I mean, God knows who would be coming out. Mm-hmm. So I think that any pot smokers I know certainly don't consider themselves criminals, and it's mm-hmm. ridiculous that it is a criminal activity. Mm-hmm. I don't know really what more to say about that, except that it's ridiculous.
And I know there have been recommendations by ARF, by Canadian Medical Association, by lawyers called, the barristers and solicitors
Bar
of Canada, the Bar Association of Canada. I mean, there's so many groups that would like to see decriminalization of marijuana, but there seems to be this elitist few that are just hanging on. And now with the passing of Bill C-7, which is in the House of Commons, where they want to increase penalties on all drugs.
Well, which is ridiculous, and again, it's the old way of thinking about things. If they haven't learned by now that rules and regulations and laws such as these do nothing to actually squash the problem. Mm-hmm. If they were effective, then we would not be having an increase in crime and drug use and all the rest of that.
Exactly.
You get rid of it, you get rid of a whole criminal element in the society. It's as simple as that.
And the
amount of hours and police resources and funds that go into the busting of people who are doing nothing but smoking pot, it seems ridiculous. Furthermore, I mean, just from my experience down on Queen Street when I used to do my street level counseling, every single night somebody would come by remarkably drunk and be obnoxious, offensive, rude, disgusting, just generally pathetic and horrible. And this is every night, mm-hmm. okay? But that's fine. It's allowed to be like that. Meanwhile, anyone who sat down who was stoned, they may be a little dazed, but they're certainly friendly. They're usually funny. And I go and they leave and I have a smile on my face. So if I could, I'd like to actually move that excessive drunkenness be considered a crime and pot be mandatory.
Yeah.
I don't see why not.
Well, in problem areas like
Okay, well, that was just a little bit of an excerpt that we had with an interview last night with Jenny Friedland, independent candidate for mayor of Toronto. And I just wanted to tell our listeners out there that if you didn't know this, if you haven't been enumerated, you can still vote. And I hear homeless people are able to vote too. So this is all you have to do. First of all, you turn off the TV or the radio, okay? You get off the couch, you go to your polling station, it's not more than 3 blocks away, and you vote. Now, if you were not enumerated, you can still vote. You just make sure you bring ID with you, some proof of address, like a phone bill or a hydro bill or your cable bill or something. And if you don't know where your polling station is, you can call Jenny Friedland at 599-7002. That's 599-7002. Or you can call City Hall at 392-6818, but they'll probably put you on hold anyway, so... So remember, if you are over 18, a Canadian citizen, and a resident of the City of Toronto, you can vote, you should vote, and you ought to vote. So, you know, that's all I need to say, Pete.
Well, what do you say about the citizenship shit?
Well, basically, anybody can vote. I heard that even people on the street can vote. I think what they need is some identification. They go down if they haven't been enumerated.
And we all know easy identification is to get if you happen to have that problem.
Yeah, that's true too.
No, especially they say that you can just say your local community center or food bank if you're homeless.
Yeah.
And they're also saying they don't usually enumerate community residences or around universities and stuff like that for the residences.
They're afraid they might vote too.
Exactly. They're expecting, you know, the Marxist-Leninists or something to come along and...
But wasn't she a nice person, though, Dave?
She is really cool. And when I read her pamphlet here, I basically said, hey, you know, if I was running for mayor, this is basically what I'd be saying, too. And everybody who I've talked to who's talked to this woman, they definitely, you know, she knows what she's talking about, and they all think she knows what she's talking about. And, you know.
Yeah, but what about her stance on the nuclear question?
The nuclear question? Yeah, we should ask her. Well, we're going to try and get her in for next week's show.
Yeah,
so.
She was talking about hydro, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, there's some silos in Parkdale, you know, that she was thinking, well, I don't know.
Well, anyway, so what's up with everyone? We got a giveaway happening?
Yeah, there's like
we have like 3 minutes of show, so if somebody out there wants a grasshopper, what is it, a t-shirt?
Yeah, okay.
We'll even throw in some pocket lint.
I want a grasshopper t-shirt.
Okay, grasshopper t-shirt. Who's playing at Sneaky Dees tonight?
Yeah.
Okay.
We're waiting for the phones. Come on, give us a call. Who's playing at Sneaky Dees tonight? You get a grasshopper t-shirt. That's all you gotta do is call.
Yeah.
595-5063. That number, 595-5063. Now, if you have a touch tone phone, the phone should be lighting up right now, and it is. Let's check this
out. Put them on the air.
CIUT. Who's this? Yes, you do. You wanna go on the air?
Do they want to go on the air?
Okay, hang on a sec, okay?
Put them on the air, Dave.
Yeah, let's
go. Hold on. It's Katrin. Should we give her the shirt?
Oh, yeah, put her on.
Okay, let's see if I can do this here. Is she there?
Katrin? Feedback. Katrin?
Tracy?
There you are.
Okay, there you are.
Katrin, why aren't you working?
Hello?
Why aren't you working, Katrin?
Yeah, they can hear you, so what's going on? Do you have your radio on?
Yeah, I do.
Who's playing at Sneaky Dees?
Grasshopper.
Who's playing at Sneaky Dees tonight?
The Grasshopper.
You've won.
There you go. You won yourself a Grasshopper t-shirt.
Katrin's on the cover of this magazine, by the way, this month. She's got a balaclava on, and she looks really menacing.
Yeah, what magazine?
Frightening.
This. I'm in
this
it, too.
This magazine.
This magazine. That's the name of the magazine, this.
So we got celebrities calling up.
There's on the inside, it's got a picture of her sitting on my head, too.
It's is it your face or your head?
It's my head. My head.
So, Katrin, what would you like to say to our listeners this week?
Fuck you.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry, we have to apologize for that statement that was a caller.
Rude.
Do you think we should take back her t-shirt for that?
Yeah, get somebody else.
Have it.
You're out of here. Sit on somebody else's head.
I still don't have it.
That's really bad. We'd like to apologize for any listeners who might have been offended by the truck stop reference, whatever that was. And,
the opinions and ideas expressed on the preceding program are not necessarily those.
Put it back on the phone, Dave.
I just hung up on her. I don't want to get taken
dusted,
off the air,
man.
Again.
I heard her,
do you?
June Rollins. Oh, dusted.
Oh boy.
tonight.
Okay, so again, tonight, Grasshopper, you guys talk for a bit there.
Yo, Ghettovision show, Grasshopper Project 9. Ghettovision is a magazine around town that you might be hearing about. And yeah, it is the freshest.
Yes, yeah, so come check it out. It'll be some hype-ass jams. I'm gonna have some DJs. We're gonna have some DJs, freestyles, Las Cholos, burritos.
And for anybody out there who's still offended, I just have to.
The opinions and ideas expressed on the preceding program do not necessarily represent the views of CIUT. CIUT FM is pleased to provide this programming time as a service to community groups and individuals. To find out how you or your group can become involved with CIUT, please phone 595-0909.
Okay. I think we should get out of here before, you know, the situation gets any worse. I'm Dave. You're listening to Uppercut. Is there anything you guys in there have to say before we go?
Yeah. How many people got good candy last night? Phone up.
Yeah, our Uppercut feedback line, 812-6860. Were you offended by the use of the F word, which our caller did? And if you were, do you think that we should have...
I didn't hear that.
I didn't always have to use that language.
I heard buck you. I didn't hear
the
F word.
She said PH.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, but if anyone was, please call 812-6860 and tell us, do you think we should have her back on the air as a result of that?
I hate you back.
Do you think we should have, do you think we should have Katrin back on the show again? You think so? Well, our listeners, call us up. You think we should have Katrin on the show, 812-6860, and, who knows, you might even win a t-shirt or something, I don't know.
Can we get some OJ talk going?
No, and it's OJ's.
We did that.
Just get rid of this OJ guy, man. I swear, man, I'm sick of this. If I see another OJ, I'm gonna pull an Elvis and shoot my TV. You know what I mean?
OJ and Nicole
Elvis style.
Anyway, we're out of here. Tuesday, 12:30 to 1 every Tuesday. We're out of here.
Come on down.
Tonight, Sneaky Dees, Grasshopper's happening. Don't forget, boycott Budweiser. They say no to drugs and supply that whole campaign because they want people to drink their beer. So, don't forget, Tuesdays, 12:30 to 1, CIUT-FM, Uppercut. Next week, it won't be so chaotic. Hopefully, we'll have Jenny Friedland in here. And coming up next is the $1.49 Jazz Show. So, have a Merry Christmas and
Happy Halloween.
And a Happy New Year. And don't forget to call the Uppercut feedback line, 812-6860. Call it often, call it now. Write it on washroom walls. Just tell all your friends, 812-6860. And if you have any comments, criticisms, or death threats that you'd like aired on next week's show, give us a call, 812-6860. 812-6860. If I have to say it again,